Hi students, welcome back. Now that you have completed the introduction section, it is time to start round one, the first of three organic post rounds. Once we move into round one, you'll first be taken to the Create Organic Social Post tab. On this tab, the first thing we want to do is watch our walkthrough video. Following this walkthrough video, we'll look at our scenario, inbox, and notifications hub before coming back to create our first set of posts. When we click on this scenario, we'll see that we have a note from the VP of Marketing. Following our scenario, we have our inbox. In the inbox this week, we have an email from the Vice President of Marketing welcoming us to the team. In this email, we can see that she's asking us to analyze the data, review the resources, and answer the associated questions in the notifications hub before moving forward to create our first set of posts. Over in our notifications hub, this week, we have four different notifications that we need to respond to. As a preview, we can look at each of these different notifications before moving forward. Once we click back on our Create Organic Social Post tab, we can scroll down since we've already watched our walkthrough video. This is a section where we will create our posts for each week. Let's start out up here looking at our budget. Our budget for our organic social posts is $500 each week. Each week we will get a new $500 to use, and thus should use all $500 each week before we click Run Simulation. As a quick reminder, we do have our scenario overview, which provides us information on our market, the analytics, our budget, and our product. We can also review our resources that has our social media marketing trends report and the Buoy social media audit. All right, after reviewing this section, it's time to make our first set of posts. To help you get started, we're going to create three sets of posts before running our simulation together. The first set of posts we're going to create are for Facebook and Pinterest. We'll start by clicking Facebook. We will add our caption. Our caption is looking at a bag with extra storage, specifically focusing on the OG tote, which is perfect for all extracurricular activities. For this one, I'm going to select a media image of a tote. When looking at each of these images, we can see we have some that are free and some that cost money. We can also see our purchased social media, which right now we don't have anything because we've not purchased anything yet. We can see advertisements. We can look at blog posts. We have holiday, image, infographic, memes, pictures, and videos. For this post, again, let's go back and type in tote, and we're going to select the Huntington tote. After reviewing the optimal times to post on Facebook, I've selected to run this post on Monday, October the 16th at 2 in the afternoon. I'm also going to run this post on Pinterest, so I can click Duplicate Post and select Pinterest. Now that I've created both of these posts, I'm going to go ahead and click Schedule Post for each one. Now it's time to create our second set of posts. This time I'm going to create one post that can be duplicated across Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and Pinterest. For this post, I have a theme for beautiful fall weather this weekend with a nature hike. So the media I'm going to look for relates to hiking. For this one, I think I will use the Escape into Nature. Here I can see that this one will cost me $250. Since my last post, I spent $0 on my media, I'm okay spending $250 on this one. Because I'm specifically looking at the weekend, I want to schedule this post to run on Friday at 9 a.m. Again, I said I want this same post to run on multiple platforms, so I can click Duplicate Post, and now my post is also scheduled for Instagram. I also want it to be on Twitter, and then finally on Pinterest. With each of these four posts scheduled, I'm going to go ahead and click Schedule Post for each one. Now I can see that out of my $500 budget, I've got $250 allocated already, and I've got $250 of my budget remaining. I can also see as I scroll down that my posts have been scheduled. I can see the date that they are scheduled for, the platform they're scheduled on. I can see my associated media, and should I need to make any changes, I can click Edit, or if I change my mind altogether, I could just click Delete. All right, let's make our last set of posts. This last set of posts, I want to be on TikTok and Instagram. So we'll start out by clicking TikTok. My post for this one is looking at back to class. We want to be fashion forward with our messenger bag. So I can click Media. And I can click or type in Messenger. When I type in Messenger, I get no results. Unfortunately, there's no specific Messenger post associated with media that is specific for TikTok. So if I take Messenger out and decide instead to type in school, now I can see I have multiple different options to select from. And I've got varying prices. Actually, on this one, I don't. So all of the media for this section is zero price. I think for this one, I'm going to select the going to school. So here I have user-generated content. It's a testimonial from a college student about what they love about their new buoy bag. I'm going to schedule this post to go on Wednesday at 2 p.m. If you remember, I said I also want to duplicate this post and have it run on Instagram at the same date and the same time. So now that I'm done with these, I can click Schedule Post, and I can see all of my posts that are scheduled. For this week, I still have a budget remaining of $250. For the purposes of our video, I'm going to go ahead and click Run Simulation. However, when you are running your own simulation, I strongly encourage you to use all of your budget each week. Because I still have budget remaining, I'm going to get a pop-up box. It tells me you have $250 remaining on your budget. Spending all of your budget, if possible, is a good idea to maximize your results. Here, I can then click Keep Working, or if I'm certain that I only want to use the $250, I can click Run Simulation. Once I click Run Simulation, I'm shown my overall results for this round. I'm going to go ahead and scroll past our walkthrough video, which we've already watched, and here I can see my analytics for this round. First thing I'm going to do is click on my post history, and then scroll down where I can see the platform, the date and time my post was published, associated media, the caption that I had, the type, and then I can see the number of impressions, clicks, engagements, and conversions, the overall cost for my media, and how much revenue I generated for each post. I can look at each platform individually. So for example, for this round, I had two posts on Facebook, so I can look at my information on Facebook separately from the posts on Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube, and TikTok. For this round, I had no posts on YouTube, so I can see that I have no awareness, no engagements, no revenue, and no post history down here at the bottom. All right. Once I finish reviewing these posts, I can go ahead and click Continue the Simulation, and I will be taken to round 2.